Welcome back to Cowabunga Corner News. In this episode, we are sitting here with Ernie Reyes Jr. at Fandom Fest 2015. And it's such an honor to see you this year, Ernie. Thank you for coming.
Actually, I'm not Ernie, and I'm lovely Katsu.
Who? Okay.
No, I'm just kidding. Today's my official day of being a cosplay player. This is my cosplay mashup. Naruto and One Piece, so I'm pretty excited about it.
Now, you've had a very, very rough year. A lot of fans are very concerned about you. How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. You know, it's been about 4 months that I've been on dialysis. And you know, you go through a lot of stages when somebody tells you, you know, out of the blue that, you know, basically going to be doing dialysis for the rest of your life, unless or until you get a kidney transplant. But you know, in some of my darkest kind of hours and kind of soul searching, you know, my family, my friends, my fans have all been so supportive. It's been kind of a blessing in disguise, being able to see kind of, you know, how much, you know, everybody kind of cares about what I'm doing. And kind of feels me to keep on going and keep fighting and keep dreaming and keep doing everything that I'm doing, you know, mostly for my family, but, you know, for everybody else as well. So there's been a lot of positive things that have come out of it, but it's a challenge. You know, I do dialysis 3 times a week, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, for 4 hours. I'm still able to travel and still work. If I'm out of town for more than a couple of days, I'll set up dialysis in the city that I'm at. So I've been lucky, but you know, it's definitely a life changer. It's definitely challenging, but you know, my martial arts training alone tells me that, you know, when you're faced with obstacles and challenges, you know, put your mind, put your body, put your spirit, and everything else you have, and you move forward. And that's what I'm doing. But I appreciate, you know, all the love and support that I've gotten from everybody all around the world. Been kind of really overwhelming in and of itself, but it's been awesome to experience.
Now you have a GoFundMe account. You have your sister set up for you. How's that been going for you?
She did an amazing thing. You know, she set up this GoFundMe account, and within I think a month raised $65,000, and that came from, you know, basically, you know, family and friends, but a lot of fans, TMNT fans, NCIS LA fans, and Last Dragon, and The Rundown, and all of these different, you know, people that have kind of, you know, seen what I've done in films and television, and it was just, I couldn't believe it.
I see in some of the comments, it's people who work with you even.
Yeah, I mean, it was really an amazing thing to experience, and it's only been about a little over a month. You know, dialysis is something that's ongoing for the rest of your life. That's what they're telling me.
Even if you get a transplant?
No, not if you get a transplant. But transplants come along with, you know, a lot of complications from the medicine and drugs that you're put on because your autoimmune system is taxed and your body's natural response to an organ transplant is to reject it. The only way that your body can survive the transplant is to be on all kinds of drugs. So there's a lot of complications that can happen because of the side effects of the drugs that you're on after you get the transplant. And of course, the liabilities and risk of the transplant. So at this point, I'm just kind of going through all the tests, and they're doing all of the work that they need to do to see, put me in front of a board. And make sure that, you know, I'm a good candidate. That when I go on a list, and that's about 3 to 5 years average time, I have actually people that are willing to donate organs. So at that point, they can go on a list, they'll get tested, and we'll see if there's somebody that's compatible. It's based upon antibodies. And so, you know, that's just something that you kind of have to cross that bridge when you come to it. But I'm so thankful for the TMNT fans, because I know that that's what we're here with Cowboy Corner and you, and there are so many fans that came out and supported me and are still continuing to support me. And I hope, you know, at places like Fandom Fest here, that I get to meet everybody and, you know, say hello and say thank you and, you know, have some fun with it. So it's very cool, and it's cool to see you as well.
So we're all really honored that you're still making out for these events, and we're all here for it. Definitely. I support everything with the GoFundMe account. I personally have made sure to get a donation, and I recommend it to anyone else who wants to be here to help Ernie. I can't express enough how much this guy has done for the fandom, even in the last 6 years. He's been here for us. Let's be there for him.
That's right, and as Luffy Akatsuki here, Fandom Fest 2015, we're signing off. Cowabunga Corner. Cowabunga.
Cowabunga!